next we have Sarah Kave, right, playing the first 100 bars of BLOCH Schelomo.
Thank you.
fantastic performance. Really great. I think on the whole it's fantastic. You know, the big challenge with this piece is it's honestly just knowing the orchestra part. I remember the first time that I played it in studio class, I was like woefully unprepared. And it didn't happen, because I played the whole thing, but it didn't happen in the section you played, but there's like one long 2T kind of in the second half. And I got completely lost. I was like trying to count, and I got completely lost. And I just came in at a random time, and I was like 15 bars early. it's hard. By the way, interesting anecdote about this piece. If you ever play it with an orchestra, there's a master class on YouTube. I don't know if you've seen it, with Kategorsky teaching this.
Yes.
So for those of you who don't know in the audience, there's something really interesting that he said, which is that he met Bloch when he was playing in Switzerland at some point. And Bloch was apparently really thrilled that he had used the music in the rehearsal, even though he was just using it for the reference of the rehearsal. He had actually memorized it. And Bloch said, like, oh, this piece, you know, I hate it when cellists play it from memory, because it's not a virtuoso piece. It's like, you know, you're a king and you have to be reading from a scroll. And I really like that, you know. So I play with the music, you know. It's nice just to have it there, because, you know, again, with the orchestra, it can be a little complex and things can definitely go wrong. I played it once, and at the very end, the bassoons completely miscounted, and it was just kind of a complete disaster. And like, they ended like a bar after me. so anything can happen, yeah.
Shall I do it again with the music?
No. But anyway, I mean, yeah, of course you should memorize it too, for your own knowledge. But it's just an interesting anecdote. Another interesting anecdote, this was like a long time ago, I can't even remember who it was, but you know, the cellos.org used to have like these interviews, and I can't remember who was being interviewed, but someone was being interviewed and they said like, oh, one of my most traumatic experiences was that one time I like showed up to a lesson with the Schelomo, and we spent the whole hour just working on the first note. It's a tough first note, yeah. But anyway, about the first note, yeah. So I've always felt that one bow is not enough. And you know, and that's just my opinion. I mean, I know Leonard Rose and yada, 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 they all do it with one bow, but it always feels too short to me. Because especially if you're taking a tempo, two, three, so it's like one, two, three. So if you do one bow, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and you have the fermata now. And that just feels very constrained to me. So I prefer it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. But anyway, that's just my opinion. You might want to consider it. But in any case, overall, the sound quality, especially for the beginning, as you know, like, you know, the orchestration is very kind of calm. You know, the percussion is like, it's very resonant. And I think overall, the sound quality should be very, you don't want to approach the string too much like this. You want to approach the string kind of from beneath. But there's always this inherent, there's a ring, a resonance, the intonation, the cello's agreeing with you, basically. Do you want to just try that right there? Nice, it feels too short to me, that's all.
I can try it with two.
No, try it, or try saving more, yeah, I mean, either one. Good. And then actually, you can come in even later now because you just more accent at the beginning, though. I think it's kind of like the creation of the universe type of thing, you know. Of course, that's the other thing. I find it harder to do at the frog if you really, to really do the right accent where you. And then you can really let the sound go. And I would let the sound peak somewhere in the middle of the down low, not at the actual change. Yeah. I'll try one more time. Keep it ringing too. Nice. Intonation watch. Yeah.
It was going a little too high and we lost the resonance.
Yeah, I mean, it's not that it's out of tune. Who cares if it's out of tune, but it's not ringing enough. One more time. Sound. That was great. I really like your rallentando. It's really ideal. Fantastic. You want to take the cadenza?
Yeah.
So if you kind of, you will not project. So you're gonna, sorry, whoever it is, you want to really. That's where you kind of want to add a little bit of portato, I think.
Yes.
In general, especially in the lower. I think it works. Just to, it's unnecessary. It's unfortunate that it has to be necessary. The next section was fantastic. Let's just skip very quickly, last thing. Here, to try from there? Ideas that kind of you might want to consider really just taking all the time you need, and then the equivalent spot would be that can be just a clear pickup. And then the last thing I'll say is that here at before 12 I would do more animando, because again you want the to not be grace note-y, very rhythmically precise, and if you're too slow, then so you just really get fast, so you can really kind of so you can play it in a tempo that feels very natural to you. So the bulk of the celerando will be the conductor's responsibility in the long notes, about 2, 3, but you can help by kind of whatever it is. Sorry, you can help by kind of pushing those forward. Yeah, fantastic. Really great.
Fantastic. Thank you.